the first thing I heard was about the invention. I didn't really know, I knew her name, but I didn't know much about her career as an actress. And so then I think I probably went to Wikipedia and I heard about the book Hedy's Folly, and I bought a copy of Ecstasy on eBay. And so, you know, there's so many conflicting stories about her life, what's true, what's not. I would tell people she dressed up as her maid and escaped, and then I'd read something else like that never happened. I'd be like, oh, I feel so foolish for having said that. And then somebody else would say, no, I think that did, a version of that did happen. And so the facts of her life seem to be so implausibly dramatic, but they just might have been. Her life was much better than probably any of the movies she ever appeared in. I think that it's really important to restore not just Hedy Lamarr, but all of these women to the history of technology, to the history of STEM, because so many of them have been erased, whether it was the women of the ENIAC project at the University of Pennsylvania, who are some of the very first computer coders and programmers in the world, who really helped invent the idea of what a computer coder is, or even Grace Hopper, who is relatively well known, but not known by the general public. And she's the driving force behind the compiler and this whole new philosophy in computer programming languages. I think so many of these women were dismissed, whether it was overt or it was an implicit or explicit bias. You know, a lot of them have been removed from the history. And so many of them contributed, you know, specifically to World War II.